Hello, this is James from the European PlayStation blog. I'm here live at E3, and I'm here with Richard from Big Big Studios.
How's it going?
Not too bad, thank you very much.
Good.
We're going to talk about Little Deviants coming to PlayStation Vita, but first of all, our blog readers will have seen a post from Simon Bursey, sort of celebrating your 10-year anniversary a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Just to sort of recap that, you know, can you tell us what is the Big Big DNA, and how have you applied that to handheld consoles throughout your history?
Well, like I say, we've been going 10 years now. We started off with some PlayStation 2 demos, and when the PSP came along, we thought, okay, that's the perfect console for Big Big. So we started with the Pursuit Force games, Pursuit Force 1, Pursuit Force Extreme Justice, and then on to Arctic Airs. And I think we're really just all about packing in a bunch of fun into that small handheld device, and we're trying to carry that forward onto Vita now.
Of course, yeah, because, you know, with Vita there's so many inputs, and it's kind of when you get a new console or a new bit of kit, you really want to sort of see everything it can do as soon as you possibly can.
Absolutely,
can't you?
And yeah.
And when I first saw Little Deviants, I thought that's a game that's really trying to do that. You're trying to use all of those varied inputs and stuff. Is there any stone untouched, do you think?
Well, we're pretty much focusing on the touch pads, the microphone, the cameras, the motion sensor, not too much on the buttons. It's funny, people are picking up the console and pressing buttons, and I'm like, no, don't do that. It's touchscreen or whatever other devices the games are using. A little bit of shoulder button usage, but yeah, we've left the analog sticks and the other buttons alone for this game.
So, when Vita was announced, previously known as NGP, of course, by the way, if you say NGP at any point, then you've got to put a dollar in a box.
Yeah, I'll try not to, yeah.
But it's, when it was announced, we saw, let me say this right. Whole roll control. Whole roll control.
Was actually a tech demo. That wasn't really a game. So whole roll control is now the game version of that technology.
So we've seen the sort of basic input. You touch the rear touchpad to lift up the ground, the terrain. Can you sort of just flesh out, you know, what it means as a game? How do you sort of progress through levels? How do you ramp up the difficulty? Things like that.
Well, a whole roll control is just one game within the Little Deviants experience. The whole product is about lots of different games, lots of different experiences using the different devices of the hardware. So that particular example, yes, is using rear touch. We deform the landscape, which rolls the deviant around. It's a fairly simple goal. You're just trying to get into a little vortex on each, and there's about 15 stages to play through, which will take you about 10 minutes when you're good at it. Pick up stars along the way for extra bonus points. And there's a little bit of a learning curve on that one, but it'll introduce you to a new way of interacting with a game using that rear touch device.
So how many games have you brought to E3?
There's four games in the demo E3. Whole Roll Control is one of those. We've got Box Blast, we've got House of Wax, and Depth Charge. And each one of those is, again, using a different aspect of the hardware.
I played House of Wax. Well, I played all of them, but I came here. But I really enjoyed House of Wax, particularly such a nice touch. You know, when they turn their back, you have to touch the rear touch
pad. Yeah, it's all about hitting the deviant in the face. So if he's facing towards you, front touch. Facing away, rear touch. Starts off easy, but it gets pretty frantic and completely messes with your mind as you play through the game.
And I mean, augmented reality is present in Box Blast. I played that before too. And you know, augmented reality, it's quite a fledgling technology. It's something that we've seen on PSP and PS3. We've had iPad, we've had Invisimal. So what do you see as the future of that?
I wouldn't say we're doing anything amazingly clever with Box Blast. We're feeding the camera image through so that you can see everything that's going on in the background, fighting the robots. You know, it's sometimes fun to shoot your friend who's just standing there, but where's that going to go? I don't know. Technology at the moment that we're putting into Little Deviants, as I say, is quite simple. I think, where's it going to go? Cameras that can actually read proper depth, project a game onto a real scene. We're seeing a little bit of that with some of the games that are coming through. Who knows? There's a lot of scope there going forward.
We sent out a tweet a while ago, so this might be a good time to bring in my transatlantic counterpart Sid to see if we've got any interesting questions on Twitter.
All right, I got one good question here. It's from Bates47 over Twitter. He wants to know, Little Deviants is such an interesting idea. Where did that idea come from, and did they plan on using all the Vita's features from the start?
Okay, well, we didn't plan on using all the features from the start. It was a very, very, very simple concept to begin with. The idea, and this was when we knew about the rear touchpad, obviously, but the idea was just a piece of cloth with a ball rolling on it. So you imagine if you hold out a piece of cloth, or get your mates to hold out a piece of cloth, put a ball on it, and push up underneath, the ball is going to roll around. And that's a very tactile experience, and we just wanted to translate that into a game. And it pretty much spiraled from there. So it's no longer a piece of cloth, it's an entire world that you can deform. And it's no longer a ball, it's a little alien creature called a little deviant.
What is a little deviant?
So the deviants are aliens. We're not going to give up too much about the story for now, but there's five different types. They all have different properties which come into play during the game. For example, there's a deviant called Pyrus, who has fire properties. The one you'll see most of, the orange one, he's called Goofer. And they're only types of deviant. They're not individual characters. There's lots of each type who exist in the world.
With the hardware, I mean, you, I presume, had as much time with PlayStation Vita as any other developer, really. And, I mean, when you first saw it, you know, what kind of genre of game did you look at it and think, yeah, that's perfect for that?
When we first saw it, I probably can't even tell you what it looked like. It was a little box. Things like analog sticks came later. I just think it's just an amazing piece of kit. It's so light, the screen is amazing. I mean, I would sit in my living room and play it, and play first-person shooters down to puzzlers. So, anything specific for it? No, I think any genre of game. You've got the social networking features that are going to be on, you know, sky's the limit.
And what about existing titles that you've seen here at E3?
Do you know what? I've had no time
really, same.
To go and look around the show floor at all yet. So I'm looking forward to Uncharted 3. Amazing. So I might go and check that out as soon as I can.
It's just down there. I can see them playing it now. I had to go on the multiplayer.
Don't tell me that.
So, I mean, further, you've got four levels here at E3.
Yeah.
When can we expect to see, you know, more games unveiled further down the line?
I think probably next shows, so Gamescom show, probably we're going to be showing some more. Yeah, we're getting on for having a near complete game there, so we'll be able to pick quite a few nice and different examples that we can show at the next set of shows.
You know, I know you're not going to go into specifics, but can you at least sort of tell us, you know, certain features that you're working with at the moment, you're thinking we're sitting on something really awesome here?
We're doing some interesting things with the rear touchpad. I mean, and in combination with the front touchpad. I mean, you may have seen in the tech demo videos before, we've got this pinch stretch mechanic where you hold both the rear and the front touchpads. There's one game that specifically uses that, which is quite cool. Microphone is going to come into play, so we might have a little bit of deviant singing.
On the bus?
Well, maybe not on the bus, but we'll have a little filter to enable you to choose the games that you want to play when you're out and about.
Another thing that you mentioned in a previous interview I did with you a couple of weeks ago is you've added like sort of calibration, so where you're using tilt, you can adjust that depending on your...
You can adjust the tilt set, basically the default tilt setting. So if you want to lie backwards in bed and play a game, then essentially you can play it upside down and it'll still function normally. You don't have to have the device just flat.
I think we're probably drawing to a close now, but kind of with somebody as much experience as yourself making handheld games, you've made a few, you know, hit portable titles. But, you know, what do you think makes a really strong portable game experience?
It's got to be the combination of wanting to play it on the go and being able to sit in your living room with the TV on and just play away. You know, I'm going to watch a movie, but I still want to play my game at the same time. I'm that addicted to it, I still want to play it. So just an experience that can transcend the home to the on the go, I think.
All right.
For me.
Thanks very much for joining us here, Richard, and really looking forward to seeing Little Deviants.
Okay.
No problem. Cheers.